So yeah, let's start off with a story. This story is from the 1990s when I was a little child. My father was posted in the army, and sometimes his only way of communication with us was to send us these cassette tapes. They would come by post, and my sister and I would gather around this cassette player, and we would hear him, after such a long time, tell us these fascinating stories. Today, sadly, I don't remember the stories themselves, but there's one thing that I do remember, and those are the morals.
Speaking of morals, I often tell my son a very simple story. There's a kid named Z who goes to class, and his friend gives him a candy to eat. He tells him, don't say anything about this to anybody. This is going to be our little secret. Well, Z comes home with a terrible, terrible tummy ache because of the candy, but doesn't say a word. Only when the mother finds the wrapper in his bag and questions him about it is when he gives in and tells her. That's when the mother gives him medicine and he feels completely fine. And she tells him, had you told me this before, you wouldn't have had to go through all the pain. Which is why it's extremely important for one to tell their mother everything. Today, my son doesn't keep any secrets from me. And I mean, in doing so, he completely ruined my husband's plan to surprise me on my last birthday, but I guess that's a small price to pay.
All of this happens because stories have a way of impacting us. Not just as children though, but at any point in our lives.
Now let's see how they've impacted you. We'd need a show of hands here. How many people in the audience feel uncomfortable when they see a black cat cross their path? Wow, that's quite a lot.
All right, how many of you would avoid standing under this tree at night?
We thought so. And how many people feel uncomfortable right now? You gotta stop that, please.
So, have you ever wondered why this happens to you? Because someone told you a story, right? And that little story completely changed the way you think today.
Now, as advertisers, Moiz and I tell stories for a living. And that, my friends, puts people like us in a powerful, powerful position. Power to change your perceptions. So now let's take a look at a few examples of stories from the world of advertising. For years, the narrative of this story has been that it's a man's world and that it's completely okay for a man to beat a woman. Let's have that sink in for a bit. Now there's another kind of story that we've told through the same medium. Here, a professional boxer says, beat me with your fists. And a renowned journalist says, beat me with your words. Here, these women are fearlessly challenging men to beat them, but at what they're good at. In this story, the woman isn't weak, she's an equal. So yes, one story told right can change the entire narrative for a gender. Moving on to our next example. Now, since a very tender age, little girls are told stories about how their parents dream of marrying them off, like their little burdens waiting to be shed off. Stories about a prince charming riding in on his high horse, whisking her away into a blissful life. But at what expense? Because for some little girls, the story turns into a nightmare.
Weddings are a monumentally huge reason for celebration in Pakistan, but it is not a happy occasion for all brides. Approximately 25,000 Pakistani girls become child brides every day, some being married off as young as 6 years old. UN women wanted to raise the legal age of marriage to 18. To show the true cost of child marriages, we hijacked the country's biggest bridal fashion show by partnering with Ali Zishan. We used the very uniform that schoolgirls wear, and by merging wedding dress embroidery onto it, turned it into the bridal uniform. As everyone celebrated the bridal collections, out walked the showstopper, a little girl in the bridal uniform. One that begged the question, are all brides meant to be celebrated? People rallied behind the cause. The stunt immediately went viral and made local and international news.
बहुत हेल्पफुल था उसको हम जो है अपने ग्रुप्स में डिस्कस कर सके.
The stunt brought the issue to the forefront, stirring more than just the internet, reminding everyone that the bridal uniform should remain a uniform.
So yes, here, the right kind of story lets little girls be little girls.
The right story can also uplift an entire community. And here's a project that we've worked on that we're extremely proud of.
Pakistan has a massive transgender community. Unfortunately, due to rampant transphobia in the country, they experience the worst forms of oppression. APTN decided to fight against transgender discrimination using a very powerful and insightful tool, the clap. This clap is used by Pakistani society to mock and direct their contempt towards the transgender community. Our idea was to use the same hands to transform ridicule into applause. A simple shift in a gesture that transforms entire mindsets. Change the clap. We launched with an online film, and for the first time ever, instead of being ridiculed, transgender people were applauded as accomplished, high-achieving Pakistanis. The campaign became the catalyst for societal movement.
Celebrities, artists, sportsmen joined the cause.
And the campaign showed up in 26 different countries. This led the National Assembly of Pakistan to pass the Transgender Rights Bill, which gives transgender people equal rights. With a simple change in behavior, we were able to change an entire society's mindset.
Thank you. All right, there's a story attached to it. Something happened the day we were filming this. It was terrible to see, actually. So Kami Sid, the transgender activist and model, she looked a little uncomfortable that day on the set in one of the scenes. And when we inquired what was wrong, she told us that some actors on the set were mocking her using the same clap. And this was happening on the set when we were recording it. We were officially disappointed, honestly. We even started to ask ourselves if this was even going to work. Something so deep-rooted, could a story truly change mindsets? But then this happened. We launched the film. Yes, and 3 weeks later, we were having a conversation with another transgender activist, Zara Chingezi. And she told us something. She said that recently she was in a washroom. There were two washroom attendants. When one of them saw her, they made the clap symbol. And suddenly, something amazing happened. The other washroom attendant stopped him and said, "Inke liye taari change ho chuki hai, ab seedhi karke bajao." Which meant, the way you clap for them. Which meant, the way you clap for them has changed, do it the right way.
So now we've seen that stories can impact society, but they're also powerful enough to change personal narratives.
Exactly, and there's a personal story attached to this as well of how stories can impact somebody as close to as your brother. So I was talking to my brother a couple of weeks back, and he tells me that he's under a lot of stress. He's 20 years old, and I was like, "Bro, you got a lot, man." Yeah, you're facing stress right now. What the hell? And I told him your problems could potentially end the day you change the word stress to obstacle. As simple as that. I'm under a lot of stress. I'm facing an obstacle. See, stress is always something that will keep you under. But an obstacle, if you truly face it, you might just overcome it. After all, how many fairy tale stories do you remember where the hero faced an obstacle and overcame it like this? Yeah, versus this other guy who started feeling stressed out.
So I'd like to share a personal story here. Growing up, I was always the kid who'd be by her mom's side at social gatherings, not wanting to meet new people or not wanting to talk to them. And because of that, I constantly had people come up to me and tell me, "Oh, look at her, she's so shy." That narrative stuck with me till my late 20s. Because that was the story I was told about myself. And so it became the story that I would constantly tell myself about myself. But I did not like this story, and I wanted to change it. And so I took a good hard look at all my accomplishments and all the new people that I had met up until that point. And most importantly, how I had dealt with the discomfort of meeting these new people, that I could finally tell myself, I am not shy. I'm somebody who likes to take their time to decide whether they want to talk to someone or not. That automatically put me in a position of power by simply switching out a negative personal story with a positive one.
Exactly. So when we walk off this stage today, we simply ask you this. The next time you do tell a story, consider this checklist. Is it plain gossip, or does it have a good moral?
Does it hurt, like this one here, or does it empower?
Does it mislead or educate?
Does it cause agony, or is it somebody's happily ever after?
Does it demotivate or uplift?
Would it then be the right story to tell?